Hello guys, welcome to our channel. Today's topic is Simulink lookup table and its use. Let's understand what is lookup table. Here I have taken an example of potentiometer. When we pull this particular cord, this drum will rotate and accordingly wiper will move on this resistive strip and we will receive an output resistance. Now, if we want to create plant model from this particular potentiometer, in that case we have to consider radius of drum, the linear length which is being pulled, and other equations of coil spring and potentiometer. Another method is we grab a potentiometer and pull this string to its maximum length, and during a particular interval we record output from the potentiometer in terms of resistance like this. So now we have two options: either we create equation from Simulink or we simply use this particular data to replicate potentiometer's behavior. So this particular table we will use as a lookup table. The lookup table is nothing but an array of data which will provide us output whenever a particular input is provided. Now let's see how to use a lookup table in Simulink. So in Simulink window, we can use library browser or simply type lookup table and select 1D lookup table. So this lookup table requires one input and it will provide one output. Let's connect input as a constant. And display block as output. In this lookup table, we'll provide our values, which we just discussed. Now we know that for input 1 we will receive output 10, for input 2 we will receive output 20, likewise for input 11 we will receive output 75, and input 13 we will receive output 19. Let's try simulating this model and check if it works as per our expectation. Now let's try to understand different settings of lookup table. When we double click on lookup table, we will see like number of table dimension. We can specify here number of table dimensions as 1, 2, 3, 4. For this example, we are considering one dimensional table. In data specification, we can specify a table and breakpoint or lookup table object. We can use lookup table object in similar way like how we have used the bus object. Now we can specify our outputs in table data and input as breakpoints. For breakpoint specification, we can specify like explicit values like how we have specified here, or we can mention even spacing. So when we select event spacing, we have to select the first point and the spacing required, and according to number of table data, Simulink will automatically create the x-axis depending on the first point and the spacing. So for example, with first point as 1 and spacing 1, if we see table and breakpoints, we can see the spacing, uniform spacing of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and values are assigned to it. If we select explicit values like what we have selected, we can see our lookup table with the specified values. We can change our data values from this tab as well, like instead of 20, we can make 24. And also we can see the plot or the response of our lookup table. Here we can change any point of this graph according as per our requirement, and we can see its effect on the lookup table. Next thing we will look into is algorithms. In algorithms, there are lookup methods, interpolation method, extrapolation method, index search method, and diagnostic out of range input. Let's see details about these points as well. We have different options in interpolation methods and extrapolation methods like linear option, nearest, and flat. So by default it is linear point slope. First we will understand what is interpolation and extrapolation with linear algorithm. So this is our lookup table. When we want to provide input as any intermediate values between breakpoints, for example 1.5, whatever output will be calculated, that will be as per the interpolation method we have selected. In our model we have selected interpolation method as linear, that's why for 1.5 we will receive output as 15. This is like we have drawn a line with slope calculated by the points 110 and 220. Similarly, if you want to specify any input which is out of range of these particular breakpoints like this will be calculated by extrapolation methods we have selected. Let's try changing our interpolation method and see its impact on the output. So with linear interpolation method for 1.5 input, we are receiving 15 as output, and for input 15, we will receive 105 as the output. Now let's change interpolation method to nearest. So for 15, we will receive input as 19, which is the last output from our breakpoint, and for 1.5, we will receive output as 20, which is nearest to 2. Since potentiometer is a linear sensor, we will use a linear point slope and as interpolation and linear as extrapolation method. We already have a video which explains about data types. In data type tab, we can select data type for breakpoints as well as the output. All other points we already covered in our previous video of data types. So this is the input to the lookup table, and these are the output of the lookup table. Lookup table is behaving as per our expectation. For each breakpoint, it is providing correct output, like for 00 it is 0, for 1, 10, 2, 20. Likewise, it is incrementing as per our expected results. Let's move to ND lookup table. I have already created model for this. Now for example, for a particular potentiometer, if the output is changing as per the temperature, in that case there are two inputs. One is the display length of the string and another is the temperature. So as per the length and temperature, our outputs will vary. So for defining 2D lookup table, we have to define two different breakpoints. So here I have defined as 1 to 3 as breakpoint 1 and 4 to 6 as breakpoint 2. So this is a 3-dimensional array. So table data will be of dimension 3x3. So for input, Let's analyze how our table data looks like. For this, we will refer to the mesh plot. For input data 1, 4, the output will be 4. So for 1, 4, output will be 4. For 1, 5, output will be 5. 1, 5, output will be 5. That is, 5 is the second element of breakpoint 2. And 1, 6, output will be 6. Similarly, for 2, 4, output will be 16. 2, 5, output will be 19. And 2, 6, output will be 20. Let's try simulating this model. For 1, 3, output is 3. For 2, 3, output is 13. For 3, 3, output is 2. For 3, 3, output is 2. All other settings for ND lookup table are similar to what we have seen for one-dimensional lookup table. That's all for today's video. If this video has helped you in any sort, please like and subscribe for more such simulation videos. Thank you.